Hey brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in North Carolina. Hope you guys are doing all right. I've got several videos to make. See how long they can stand being in the bathtub there, the family. Anyway, brothers and sisters, just a FYI update or announcement. I'll be in West Virginia, Bridgeport, West Virginia, the 19th and the 20th. That's a Saturday and Sunday of July, the 19th and 20th of July. I will be in Nashville on the 24th. Then, by the grace of God, I don't know exactly how I'm gonna, which way I'm gonna go. If I'll go to Dallas first, I mean, I'm still waiting on direction from the Lord, but the Lord has specifically told me to go to Seattle. So right now, I'm trying to get a vehicle. I mean, I've got a vehicle now that I need to return, basically August the 7th. And I'm planning on driving to Seattle, not flying, because I don't know how long I'll be there. And I need a vehicle to get around because I've got people that I'm going to be seeing, groups of people spread out over, you know, hundreds of miles from Portland up to Vancouver, all over that whole area. And it's not a, you know, in just in the cities, but, you know, most people don't live in the cities that I'm seeing, as a matter of fact. So I ask you guys to pray about that. As you know, how that'll come together, I don't know, but I know the Lord will make a way. The Lord provides. And I know he will. Now, just how he'll do it, that's the whole thing. And that's, he's an on-time God, you know, just like when the children of Israel were facing the Red Sea. They didn't know he was going to part it. As a matter of fact, they didn't have no faith. Only, you know, basically Moses did, and maybe Aaron and those guys did, it doesn't say. And Joshua, some of the people probably had faith, but they didn't know that God was going to part the sea. I mean, he could have just, you know, sent down lightning and an earthquake or whatever and killed the Egyptians right there without parting the Red Sea. You know, who knows? So they didn't know until, you know, it was going to happen what God was going to do. But he did deliver them and he made a way. That's how God is. He's an on-time God. So whatever's your situation, you know, I'm on here as an example to you. That's why the Lord put me on here, for on YouTube, as an example to the brethren to walk by faith and not by sight. You know, that was the name of my ministry until I changed it to Joshua's Ministry. The name of my ministry was Walking by Faith Ministries. I've had that. That's the title that the Lord gave me when I first started back in January, you know, when I went live with my ministry January 2001, when I first started preaching. I started actually answering the call and started, you know, in October of 2000. Anyway, brothers and sisters, let me see which one of these things I want to talk about. The Lord will give me lots of things. Let me make a quick one. You know, and I mentioned this a little bit the other day, and the Lord was just really putting this on me just the last few minutes while I was praying. The Bible says in Luke, it gives the genealogy of Christ in reverse. In Matthew, it starts with like Abraham or what, and comes down. And Luke, it goes backwards all the way to Adam. And then when it says like Jesus, who was the son of Joseph, who was the son of, you know, and then, you know, whatever, all that all the way through. You know, David, who was the son of Jesse, who was the son of Boaz, and on and on and on. So, anyway, it says Adam was who was the son of God. You know, and I was just, right now, just a few minutes ago, the Lord just dropped it on me. It's really cool. To, you know, word from the Lord and a nugget of gold. Adam was a son of God. Why? Because God took the clay, the earth, Adam means red earth man. Adam was made out of the dust of the ground. God breathed on that and breathed life into Adam. And that's why Adam was a son of God, because, you know, he was inspired by God, inspiration of God. The Ruach Elohim is the Hebrew. All of you people who love to try to speak Hebrew and think that it makes you more sanctified, there's a little Hebrew for you. The Ruach Elohim, you know, it's the breath. Ruach is breath, the breath of God, Elohim, of the Creator. Elohim refers to God as the Creator. You know, that's one of the names of God. And every name of God is not really his name, but a revelation of who is God and an attribute of who is God. All the names God gave, like El Shaddai, God Almighty, it was a revelation that God is Almighty. So, God, we only see little angles. We just see through a glass dimly, and we just hear it, see a little bit something about the attributes of God. So those names that people are tripping on, all these Old Testament names for gods are really just attributes and revelation that some man of God got from about God and wrote it down. Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Jireh, all those different names. It's a revelation of who God is and what God does. That's what it means. It's not like, hey, what's up, Tom? You know, it's not like a personal name like we're talking. The personal name that God gave us was Jesus, or in Hebrew, Yeshua. That's the personal name that God gave us. And then Yeshua, who is God, said that we should call God the Father, Heavenly Father. He didn't say call Him Yahweh and all that. He said call Him our Father, who art in heaven. Hallowed be Thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven, all that. But what is known as the Lord's Prayer. But actually, the Lord didn't pray that. He was teaching the apostles how to pray. It's really the apostles' prayer or the church's prayer, because Jesus was telling them how to pray. That's not how the Lord prayed. He was saying, this is how you should pray. Anyway, just a little nitpicky point there. Anyway, so God breathed into the dirt that He formed into the shape of a man, into His own image, in His own likeness made He them. You know, made He him. Made they him. Well, I'm getting all my pronouns all mixed up. You know what I'm saying? You know what it says. So God breathed into that dirt and made Adam. And so in John chapter 1, it says to them who believe on Jesus, to them He gave power to become the sons of God. So when we get saved and we're sealed with the Holy Spirit, God breathes on us, then we become children of God. You know, I've mentioned this many times. It's true. All these New Agers and all these people out there, even lots of Christians, are saying, oh, we're all children of God. No, the Bible says that we're enemies of God, strangers from Israel and strangers from the covenant of God. And then when we get saved through the blood of Jesus, Jesus gives us the power to become the children of God by His Spirit. So God breathes on us and seals us with His Holy Spirit, just like He breathed on the apostles. I'm not talking about baptism and Holy Spirit. That's a separate, further work of the Holy Spirit in our life. And then being filled with the Holy Spirit for different things, for the gifts of the Spirit, whatever. It's filled with the Holy Spirit to preach. But when we're sealed with the Holy Spirit, God breathes on us and we become children of God, just like Adam. You know, what was lost with Adam is recovered when we become born again. We become children of God like Adam was. That's why even the Bible calls Jesus the second Adam. You know, He came and didn't sin. He came perfect, like Adam was perfect and sinless. He was given the option to sin, and He chose to sin. Jesus came sinless and perfect, was given a choice to sin, but didn't do it. Jesus was tempted in every way, but without sin, the Bible says. So that's why He's known as the second Adam. He came and did what Adam should have done and didn't do, because Adam was only a man, and he had the chance to sin, and he took it. Jesus, being God in the flesh, God Himself provided the sacrifice. As I've talked about before, even as Abraham prophesied when he was going up the hill with Isaac, and Isaac said, Father, where's the sacrifice, when he was going to sacrifice Isaac? And Abraham said, God Himself will provide a sacrifice. God provided Himself. The Bible says, great is the mystery of godliness, that He was manifested in the flesh, right? Seen of angels, taken up in glory. I didn't say the whole verse correctly. Jesus is God, fully God and fully man. Brothers and sisters, I'm going to cut this off because I've got some more videos the Lord is leading me to make.